This is a situation that has affected everybody, but at the end of the day, God remains to be faithful, and we continue to thank God and to appreciate God for his faithfulness, which never fails. I want to read John chapter 1, chapter 14, brother, and verse 1. The Bible says, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me." And then I will read Psalms 13, verse 3 to 5. The Bible says, "Consider and hear me, O Lord, my God. Lighten my eyes, lest I sleep the sleep of death. Lest my enemy say, I have prevailed against him. And those that trouble me rejoice when I'm moved. But I have trusted in thy mercy. My heart shall rejoice in thy salvation." What a passage. Father, in the name of Jesus, as we come to hear your word, we want to bless you. And we are asking you in the name, above every other name, the name of Jesus, that you will heal our lives. That by this word, you will transform our lives. That where there was fear, Lord, you will put courage. Where there was no hope, Lord, you will restore hope. In the name of Jesus, I pray for my viewers, wherever they are, give them the spirit of understanding. Let the spirit of God help them, even to be able to agree with your word. And let this word become a seed of greatness in their spirits. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. I'm going to be bringing to us a message that I have called, Why We Can Trust God. Why We Can Trust God. The scripture that I've read there, one of it, Jesus speaking and telling his disciples, there is no need for you to be troubled. No matter what you go through, there is no need for you to be troubled. If he was here right now, he would tell us not to be troubled by COVID-19 or coronavirus. Just put your trust in God. And also, believe me, trust me. And then David says that, "I pray that you're going to lighten my eyes, open my eyes, for me to see that this is not the end. For me to see that this is not my end. I don't want to sleep the sleep of death. Come and rescue me so that my enemies will not say that we have defeated him, we have prevailed against him." I want you to know that the devil will not have the last laugh. The devil will not have an opportunity to say that he has defeated you, because God is together with you and we can put our trust in him. I want us to know, I want us to look at some of the reasons why we can trust God. Some of the reasons why we can trust God. Trust is a maintainer of relationship. No relationship can survive without trust. We have a relationship with God. He's our Father. And if we are going to maintain that relationship, there has to be trust. So why can we trust God? Why can we trust God? Number one, because our God is not a liar. Because our God is not a liar. Man can lie to you, but God has never lied. God never lied to Abraham. When he told him to leave his people, his family, his country, and go to a land that he will show him, though he did not see it, he believed God. He trusted God and he started the journey. and went without even seeing or without knowing where he was going. But because God had told him to leave his nation, to leave his people and go to a place he will show him, he trusted God and he went. And we all know that God did not lie to Abraham. He told him he will give him children. He told him he will give him a son. And that through that son, he will become a father of a great nation. And today we know Israel is a great nation. That was a promise from God. God is not a liar. The Bible says that let every man be a liar, but God cannot lie. Romans chapter 3 and verse 4. Let God be true, but every man a liar. Your parents can lie to you. Maybe without even knowing, they can promise you something that they will not be able to deliver. But when God promises you something, is able to deliver. Our God is able to deliver his promises. Praise the Lord. So there is no need for you to be worried. You can trust God. In this situation, whether you are working or not, I know even those that are working, businesses have been affected. But the truth is, God doesn't need your business to supply for your needs, to provide for you. Our God is able to provide for you supernaturally. And so I pray that you will see the hand of God working in a supernatural way to provide for you, to provide for your children, to provide for your family in the name of Jesus. Indeed, we shall not die, we shall live to declare the works of God. Somebody shout a believing hallelujah. Somebody may say, Pastor, how can we trust God when he allows all this evil to come to us? Well, not every evil is evil. Even in evil, God can do something good. Even where there is evil, God can still do something good. Look at this. When Jesus was crucified, and I want you to know that the crucifixion of Jesus was orchestrated by religious leaders. And that was a great evil in the eyes of man. But that crucifixion, though it was evil, God turned it into salvation of man. It was an evil, but God used that evil to save humanity, to save you and I, to save the whole world. And today, though he was crying at the cross there, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, why, my God, why have you forsaken me? He was crying there, and the people that were there following him, they looked at him crying, desperate, wondering what would happen. This was supposed to be the Messiah. At least that is what we were told, or that is what we believed. But look at it now. He is hanging there at the cross. Our hope is gone. Our confidence is gone. What are we going to do now? Why does God have to bring this evil to us? Why is Zipri allowing this evil to come to us? Well, I am here to tell you, not every evil is evil. Some evil, God can do something good even in the midst of that evil. Praise the Lord. If God is in that evil cannot be called evil. God is together with us even in this situation. And therefore, we cannot call it evil. So regardless of what is happening in your life, regardless of whatever has gone down because of this situation, whatever is not working because of this situation, I want you to know that as long as God is in the situation, you cannot call it evil. This is not evil because God is together with us. Shout hallelujah if you believe. Shout a believing hallelujah if you believe. Why should we trust God? How can we trust God? Number two, because what is impossible with man is very easy with our God. What is impossible with man is very easy with God. Maybe it is a sickness. Maybe it is a situation that man said this one is not possible. Maybe you are looking at yourself. You're wondering where to get house rent. You're wondering how to feed your children and your family. And you have gone to everybody who you thought they were your friends. And they have turned you. They have told you that they are not able to help you. They have told you they are not able to help you because even themselves, they do not have enough help. I want you to know that when everybody is not able, God is able. When people are not able, there is a God in heaven who is very much able. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I say praise the Lord. So we can trust God because even when men are not able, things that are impossible with men, God is able to do them. To God, all things are possible. That is what the Bible says. Luke chapter 18 and verse 26. I will read up to 27. And they that heard it said, who then can be saved? That is how people today are asking, who can be saved? When you hear news of how people are dying, how many people are dying, you are asking yourself, who can be saved? I am here to tell you that God will save you. Hallelujah. Amen. And he said, the things which are impossible with men are possible with God. Things that are not possible with man, things that the United States is not able, things that the UN, WHO is not able to manage, God is able to do them. Our permanent solution is not with man. Our solution is not with the government. Our solution is with God. Shout hallelujah if you believe. So don't fret, don't fear when you hear news, when you listen to news, when you see people dying. Powerful people are dying, rich people are dying, but you shall not die. Shout hallelujah. I decree that you will not die. I say you will not die in the name of Jesus. Why should we trust God? Because number three, God is willing to help us. Because God is willing to help us. I have a passage here I want to read from Matthew chapter 8. I will read verse 1 up to 3. The Bible says, when he had come down, that is Jesus, from the mountain, great multitudes followed him. And behold, a leper came and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. Then Jesus put out his hand and touched him, saying, I am willing. Be cleansed. Immediately his leprosy was cleansed. Look at what Jesus is saying. This is a situation that nobody was able to help. No physician was able to help lepers. Nobody was able to help lepers. Once you get leprosy, it was a dangerous disease. Nobody would come near you. You would not be allowed to touch anybody. You will not be allowed even to stay with your family. You will not be allowed even to stay within the city. Those days, a leprous would be put outside the city. They would lock the gates and leave him out there, outside the gate, to be eaten by the animals of the world. Can you see that? It was a dangerous disease. It was a bad, bad disease. And this man was a leper. He heard about Jesus and he went to Jesus and he told Jesus, if you're willing, you can make me well. You can cleanse me. And Jesus said, yes, I am willing. And he stretched his hand, touched him and cleansed him. Today, God is willing to help you. God is willing to help your family. God is willing to help your business. God is willing to help your children. And therefore, this situation will not kill you. This situation will not finish you. You will not perish. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm so excited. I'm so excited to know that I can trust God, because God is not just waiting for me to pray. He's actually willing. Even before I pray, He's willing to help me. Remember, He said in Jeremiah 29 and verse 11, "For I know the thoughts that I have towards you." NIV says, "I know the plans that I have for you. The plans of good, not of evil. Plans to give you hope and a future." Plans to give you hope and a future. That is what God wants for you. So I will see you after coronavirus. I will see you and I will greet you. We will fellowship again, because God will keep you. Hallelujah. I am so excited. So don't worry. Just put your trust in God. Why? Because God is willing to help you. And from this story, I would like us to look at some of the activators of the help of God. Activators of the help of God. As we go to conclude, how to activate the help of God. Number one, it is through worship. Through your worship. The leper said, "And behold, a leper came and worshipped him." That is what the Bible says. "And behold, a leper came and worshipped him." That is the text that we read in Matthew chapter 8 from verse 1 to 3. "And behold, this leper came and worshipped him." That was the first key. That was the first key. Exodus chapter 23 verse 25. If you read New International Version, that is NIV, the Bible says, "Worship the Lord your God, and His blessing will be on your food and water. I will take away sickness from among you." Look at that. Look at that. The leper activated the help of God through his worship. When he came to Jesus, he bowed down and he worshipped him. He worshipped God. And that is what activated the help of God. So don't forget to worship God. Even at home, every day, when you wake up in the morning, the first thing before you go to WhatsApp, before you go to Facebook, make sure that you honor God with your worship. Bow down before God. You can kneel down just beside your bed. You can leave your husband sleeping and kneel down. Or even better, you can agree with your husband that every morning before we do anything, at 5 in the morning, we will be waking up and we worship God. We bow down, we kneel down before Him and we worship Him. And you will see how God will help you. May the Lord help you. I say, may the Lord help you. Worship is not just a song. Worship is not just bowing down and singing a song. Worship is submission and surrender to God. What is worship? Worship is submission and surrender to God. And that is how you activate the help of God. When you surrender to God, when you submit to God, when you pour your heart before God, like David, he said, "I know it's not my money you want, it's not my sacrifice you want. What you want is my broken heart." When you bow before God, surrender to Him, submit to Him, you will activate the help of God. What is worship? Worship is a declaration of love towards God. A declaration of love. It is when you bow before God and you tell God how much you love Him, how how much you love him. Inside the matatu, you can be worshiping God without anybody hearing. You can just be worshiping God, telling God, thank you. Father, I love you. Jesus, I love you. Inside the matatu, you can just burst out in tongues and pray and worship and declare your love for God. And that is worship that is going to activate the help of God in your life. May the Lord give you the grace and the wisdom to worship God. Amen. What is worship? Number three, worship is a confirmation of dependency to God. It's a confirmation, a declaration of dependency. It is where you pour out your heart to God and you genuinely ask God for help. You genuinely ask God for help. You tell God, here, it's not my education. Here, it's not my money. Here, it's you. If you don't come, I will perish. If you don't come, my enemies are going to rejoice because I'm going to be destroyed. I'm going to be defeated. Oh, that is worship. That is worship. The key of worship. The key of worship. Wherever you are, maybe you can just lift up your hands before the Lord and just declare to God how much you love him. Just declare to God how you love him. Just declare to God how you depend on him. The key of worship. The second key, I may not have a lot of time to give us more keys, but maybe this will be our last for now. We can activate the help of God through triggering the will of God. Triggering the will of God. The lepers came to God and said, this is what the Bible says, Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. That is what the leper said. Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. If you're willing, you can make me clean. If you're willing, you can make me clean. He was triggering the will of God. It's very clear. 1 John chapter 5 and verse 14. And this is our confidence, that if we ask anything in accordance to the will of God, God will hear us. So we are sure that if we pray according to the will of God, our prayer will not go to waste. Our prayer will be answered. Our prayer will be answered. If we pray according to the will of God, any journey you take according to the will of God, that journey will be successful. Anything you do in the will of God, it will not fail you. Anything you do, anything you start in the will of God, it is bound to succeed. I decree that as you engage the will of God, as you trigger the will of God in your life, for your family, for your career, for your business, for your ministry, as you trigger the will of God, you will not fail. I say you will not fail. 2020 will be the best year for you in the name of Jesus, because you are going to remain in the will of God. You are going to remain in the will of God. Hallelujah. And maybe the last one, by going to God for help. And behold, a leper came. Behold, the leper came. He came to Jesus. Jesus said in John chapter 6 verse 35, I am the bread of life. He that cometh to me shall not hunger. He that cometh to me, I am the bread of life. If you do not have a job right now, if you are not able to go to work, God, Jesus, is the bread of life. If you come to him, you will not hunger. He will not disappoint you. You will not be hungry. Praise the Lord. If we go to Jesus, he can help us. If we go to God, he can help us. This morning, we are still in the morning. If you can just go to God, if you can just go to God, if you can just go to God right now, he can help you. Maybe you are not even born again. If you can just come to Jesus, He's the bread of life. You will not perish. You will not be destroyed. Some of you are fearing. Some of you are told by people that there is a witch somewhere. There is somebody somewhere who did something about your life. And that is why you don't prosper. That is why you don't succeed. I am here to tell you that if you can come to Jesus, all that can be a thing of the past. All that can be a thing of the past. If you can just go to Jesus, stop going to people. People don't have your help. It is only Jesus who has your help. It is only Jesus who has your help. The Bible says, "For what the Lord doeth, it shall be for good." Anything that God will do for you, people have turned you down. Your parents, you went to your parents, they turned you down. But Jesus will never turn you down. If you come to Jesus, He will lift you. The Bible says that even when my parents, when my mother, my father drop me, when they forsake me, the Lord shall take me up. If you come to Jesus, He will not fail you. Maybe you are not born again. I want to pray with you. Wherever you are, you have not given your life to Jesus. I want to pray for you right now. I want to pray for you right now. Wherever you are, wherever you are, you are in the matatu. You don't need even to kneel down. You don't need even to lift up your hands. Wherever you are, just believe that Jesus is your help. That Jesus is the only help that is permanent. So I want you to repeat this prayer after me. Say, "Lord Jesus, I come to you. Help me. Forgive me. Save me from everything that I have done against you. Forgive me of my sins. Today, I receive you in my heart, in my life. Today, I believe you to be the Lord and Savior of my life. I am born again. Thank you, Jesus. Amen." If you have prayed that prayer, you have given your life to Christ. Welcome to the family of God. Now you are born again. Look for a fellowship. Look for a pastor who can help you grow. A pastor who believes in the Bible and in the Holy Spirit. And so that you can be able to grow. For the rest of us, wherever we are, maybe you are sick somewhere, I speak healing into your body right now. May the Lord touch you wherever you are. Wherever you are feeling pain right now, I command that pain to die in Jesus' mighty name. I decree it is well with you. As you begin this new week, I declare that you shall not die. You shall not contact coronavirus. The Lord will protect you. The Lord will cover you with the blood of Jesus. You are surrounded with a wall of fire. I shall see you in Jesus' mighty name.